I was in pre-cal, and it took a little while for me to realize that this was alcohol poisoning and hazing, and it just didn't make sense, because this is Carson. This isn't like some person you hear about, you know, on the news. This was someone that I like loved and someone that I knew.
It's just like having a like partner in crime, kind of. You definitely feel a sense of loneliness when he's not here anymore.
Why is no one helped him? I don't understand.
Nobody wants to lose a best friend.
Our relationship was short-lived, but I could tell he was the type of person that I would have become very good friends with.
I miss our experiences that we had together in San Luis Obispo, and it's so hard to know that that is forever gone.
My son's not here to share things with me, to laugh, you know, to play, to go ride our bikes, to meet the new girlfriend, have grandchildren.
It's still hard to look at pictures because he was just a picture of fitness. He was a beautiful, beautiful child. So that's hard.
What do I miss the most? I miss Carson.
Carson wasn't just a college kid who died from alcohol. You know, he was, you know, he had a family that doesn't have him anymore, and you know, he had a huge group of friends back in Texas that, you know, don't have him anymore, and he left our group of friends here too.
You can tell that he was part of such a good family, a close friend to everyone, so kind, and he's gone now for such a dumb reason that he's gone. There's no, he should be here right now.
I want to communicate to people is just to make good decisions that are going to be lifelong good decisions.
It's better to be safe than sorry in every situation. If you're not like that, if you don't go about life like that, then you could end up without a friend like a lot of us are today.